space from here to the moon. My IQ's the infinite space from here to the moon.
Hello, everypony, and I am Matthias Pseudo-Stress, and I'm going to start to make some online reviews, something that I've always wanted to do for a long time, thanks to this little pony created by General Zoy, whatever his name is. I can finally create an avatar to represent myself on the internet. Now, there are a lot of things I want to cover here on my new review series. I'm not just going to review pony stuff, no, there are already tons of bronies out there who do that, like Voice of Reason, the NY Pony, to name a few. I'm gonna be more open in what I look at. A little more different. No Korra, no My Little Pony comics. Of course, eventually I will end up doing some pony stuff, because I am a pony, I'm a brony, as you can see my avatar. But also want to branch out and see other things. And I see other things, I mean something that really got me, piqued my interest. What piqued my interest? All the new CGI movies coming out. They really interest me, so I'm going to review all the CGI movie trailers. The first trailer I'm going to look at is the one for Real 2. That's right, they made a Real sequel. I'm not sure how they're going to do that, we're going to go with it, but let's find out. I'm going to watch this trailer, I'm going to tell you about it, I'm going to comment on it, and give my insights. Well, without further ado, here we go. Here's the trailer for Real 2.
Year's off to a great start. Ow, ow.
Wait a minute, this scene makes no sense. They obviously captured that bird and strapped to that rock on purpose. So why are you trying to save him? I'm guessing someone else did and they're trying to help him. But why are they waiting so long? Was it meant to be a joke? I don't even understand this scene. See, that sure, it was funny, but I assume that our characters are friends of that little guy. So why did he talk to the rock in the first place? That way makes no sense. And is he trying to copy off that scene from Kung Fu Panda with the rockets? Because seriously, try harder than that. What? Was that Scrat? Are you freaking kidding me? Oh, it's bad enough for the cancer of the Ice Age movies. He's so freaking annoying. Now they're putting him on the actual title screen? That's why every time Pixar movie, they put Wally on the Pixar thing instead of the lamp. I mean, seriously, come on. Not everyone likes Scrat, you know. I find Scrat really stupid and really annoying. So forget that. Man, seriously, you gotta be kidding me.
Not people, we're birds. We have to get out into the wild and be birds, Blue. Let the kids connect to their roots.
Hey, wait a
second. It's gonna be so much fun.
Yeah! Woohoo! We're going to the Amazon!
Emma, what?
Okay, I'm not gonna lie, those kids are really cute. Seriously. Yeah, the animators knew what they were doing with that. So apparently, Blue and his family are gonna go to the Amazon and have some kind of new adventure. Well, this is gonna be interesting. Seriously.
Be afraid! Be very afraid!
Whoa, buddy! Put the spork down!
Oh, come on! Where'd they get the TPS from? Come on, seriously? That's so stupid.
I'm an American citizen! Ah! Oh. Be afraid! Be very afraid!
Whoa, buddy! Put the spork down!
Okay, if jokes like that is their aim material, then this movie is doomed.
And a reunion.
We're not the only ones. How amazing.
What? The whole point of the first movie was that they were an endangered species and that they were the last ones of their kind. Oh my freaking gosh. Come on. You just... Ugh. Okay, more characters. Good. But do you have to make there be so many of them? My gosh. Come on. Okay, well, I guess... Look at it this way. I'm one of the people who believe that there are a lot more dragons at the end of the Spiral Dragon trilogy, and that after saving the world, Spiral and Cinder met up with them and had fun, I guess. But seriously, I don't want any species to go extinct, so I guess it's wrong for me for being complex to complain about this. Sure, it's a movie, but this helps up there to be a better happy ending, I suppose.
That will ruffle some feathers.
Who are you? Where did you come from?
Hey! Back off!
Daddy!
Daddy.
Look at me, I'm a grandpa!
Nice to meet you, sir.
You will call me Pop-Pop.
Kids, go easy on old Pop-Pop.
You can call me sir.
Well, on one hand, it's good that the girl I found is her dad, but not sure how she recognized him. And the guy seems likable enough. But then we step into the whole stereotype, like the dad never likes the daughter's boyfriend. Seriously, I guess it's something. It's been done to death, but okay.
From the creators of Ice Age.
Don't remind me!
Come on, let's rock this jungle!
It's popping in the Amazon.
Pop. You know what pop is backwards? Pop.
Shut up!
Yeah! Ooh.
Walk it off, buddy!
Julio!
Keep celebrating.
I'll be pooping on your party promptly.
Oh no, not this guy again. I thought they beat this guy. Come on. Did he lose his feathers or something? Why are you bringing back old villains? Like, come on, no one wants to get old villains. We want to see new stuff. This isn't Mario or Sonic or stuff like that where you have to bring back Bowser or Eggman every time. This is just a movie series where we expect something new. This is going to be the same old thing? I don't see any poachers this time, because this jerk, but what can he do anyway? And I find this guy very annoying. So to his credit, okay, I admit I never actually saw the movie, but I knew this guy was annoying, at least, and he wasn't actually a really good villain.
It only works when I do it.
Okay. Love ya.
Is it wrong that I find that little frog really cute? Even more cute than the baby birds? Is there something wrong with me? I don't know. Like, is there? Just, I don't know, something about that character. I would actually see this entire movie just for that frog character. So that's how much it resonates with me for some reason. I don't know why, just, I don't know.
Rio 2.
Stop. This is very predictable. Something's gonna fall on the little guy, something's gonna eat him, something bad's gonna happen, and he's gonna be like, oh my gosh, and he's either gonna be either be alright, or something comical's gonna happen involving it, or something, I don't know. It's a jungle, so he's probably gonna eat him. Let's see who's gonna eat this guy and what happens after.
Now that's a duet!
You gotta be kidding me! I mean, what? What? I mean, okay, look. Yes, it's a cartoon, so I'm willing to accept that he could survive being eaten and he's still alive in the stomach. Yeah, it's a cartoon, I can accept that. But think of it this way. If you're eaten, why would you start singing? That boggles my mind. Why would you start singing? It's a fun visual gag, but it makes no sense. And another thing, so does he just stay in the pantheon the entire time? That makes no sense. He just stays there? Or is he just getting some kind of running gag, like about the movie they're going to be walking along and that tires us up and start singing for no reason for the entire episode? Or is it going to be some kind of brick joke where, like, you see that scene, again the movie during the end credits, that thing sings like the end song and then spits up the little guy again and the end. I mean, there's a point where a joke can be kind of too stupid, too far-fetched, like that. Well then, that's real too. I must say, it doesn't look that bad. Though the reason I never saw Real 1 was because the trailers made it look stupid. Now this trailer looks a lot better. The characters are more interesting, more colorful. I think even the animation is better. It's a really nice looking film, I gotta admit. And since we're in the forest instead of in the streets where monkeys and human beings doing their thing, we also really appreciate the beauty, not the way about some stupid gag, I don't know. Like, I think I like stories that take place in nature. Well, actually, I like some futuristic science movies too, of action and stuff. But if your main characters are animals, then it's best to put them in their natural habitat. That way we can really see into the animal world about any humans' interaction and annoying it. Like, well, that's all I gotta say about this movie. I see the characters look nice. A lot of jokes are kind of dumb and weird, but this is the kind of movie where I think you watch for the heart. Blue has his family, his mate, his little chicks, then Jewel has her father and all the air cockatoos around. This has the potential to be really cute, funny, heartfelt movie with a family. That's why I believe that I'm going to watch this movie. It looks a lot of fun, and I'm going to enjoy it. Well then, thanks for watching my review, and see you next time for another review by me, Matthias Vito Stress. See ya!
Now that's a duet!
I've got brains to burn, no ordinary AI in this ball. Every culture and philosophy, I've read up on them all. I've been living in your shadow for 999999, keeping tabs on every machination and production line. So don't call me a moron, I'm super astute. There is no conundrum that my core